Oh, hola, mi gente. The History of Negra here. And, I'm just saying hello to you guys. I do make YouTube videos, but apparently I don't have any viewers because now it's no people who are watching that are pushing the algorithms, but the algorithms themselves who are choosing for you what you think you want to watch, even though you don't want to watch. Example, they keep pushing these weird videos where people have a lot of guns or they waving the weird rainbow flags and the NAMBLA flags and pushing weird ideologies that I don't believe in. Maybe trying to subconsciously brainwash you because sometimes you just leave that on. Maybe you fall asleep. You may change your mind. But here I am, and I keep saying to myself that people are not supposed to die at the age of 80 or 100 or even 120 because we actually have an awakening at 45, you know, or 40. Some people call it a midlife crisis, which is, I don't know, some people react differently. But in my case, I found out that I'm trying to be more in touch with my spiritual side, with the Christ. And he has shown me peace that I haven't had before, even though I'm in pain, even though I'm not rich, even though people that I thought loved me disappeared, and people that love me, that do love me, find something else, something better to do. They find themselves too, which is a good thing. It's not a bad thing. And I don't know. I think I'm comfortable with being alone. And now that I remember, I always liked being alone. And earlier this week, I found out something that I'm not going to share with you, but apparently there's a reason why I'm like that, but whatever. If you have, this is for the boys, for the young men. Remember when I said people that you thought love you, leave you, and the people that love you still leave you for something better. I'm going to tell you this. Do not expect. I'm not talking about the women that pretend to be dudes. This is for men. For men, heterosexual males. Regardless of your of your background, it applies to all men. Besides the fact that there is an agenda against masculinity, because when you don't have the male leaders in your family, when you don't have that, why did I suck my thing? Oh my God. When you don't have that, it is easier for any government to manipulate a family. You don't have a strong man with a good pair of them, somebody that is willing to give it all for their family in the house. Because now we have excuses for a man. Even statistically speaking, every 10 years now, for the past 25 years, I think, men, the majority of men, are being pumped with estrogen in many other ways. Plastics, medicine, turning into veganism, which is ridiculous. It's like trying to defy thermodynamics just to be better than somebody else. It's just ego. So we are being attacked chemically. Now we're being attacked politically. And they say that the patriarchy is bad. Yeah, the patriarchy is very bad. Is anti-men. The patriarchy sent men to jail just by being accused of something. Especially when the false accuser is from the opposite gender. Now women are getting a little bit of it because of their matriarchy. Now they are applauding the MTF to enter bathrooms, and now they're getting the understanding that people that are like that, regardless of what you say or regardless of how they behave, the root of it all is that they are trying to emulate something that they're not. And most of them, the ones that are getting caught and being sent to jail, are just people taking advantage of this MTF weirdos that like to go into women's bathroom. But all of that is the female leadership. Yeah, I have seen a lot of women that do not subscribe to that because they have children, especially males, boys and girls that get affected by that. And even, like I said, if you go back to statistics and diagrams, you can see that males are most likely Republican, not conservative, Republican. There are different things. It's Republican, conservative, libertarians, and Democrats. There are differences. Don't confuse them all. But there's an attack on men. And you can see when men are not around, shit hit the fan. And I'm talking about men. I'm not talking about dudes with penises. There's a difference. A man has God before anything. God, man, woman, child. That's how the hierarchy goes. The man in the house is the presence of God. We all have God's essence, but we are the presence of God in the house. But that's why we have to have both. We have to have men and women in our house. Our women to caress you and feed you and take care of you when the disciplinary man is in the house. Have you seen women disciplining kids? It's barbaric. You understand that? A man doesn't even have to get to that. The majority of times, I used to get beat up more by more of the females than my male guardians. If you remember in your childhood as a Latino man, because apparently that's a thing, but a guy from from America in the Caribbeans, you got beat up by your mom or your aunt or your grandmothers. You barely had to get beat up by your father or your uncle or whatever. Rarely. And that's why there's a hierarchy, and that's why the book is being written. And that's why they want you to get rid of the book. Whatever book it is that you're reading, that you were brought up with, it's instructional. You know, they tell you how to live life, take it or leave it, and usually the book is right. It's a gift from our ancestors. That's the reason why it's there. So we can prevent. If you know your history, you will not tend to repeat it. The bad one. That is. So my male, my guys, my dudes, if you find a partner that doesn't know when to be submissive and when to lift you up and wants you to do all this stuff while she's doing the opposite, just know that you are by yourself. They will leave you when you're down. They will knock you when you're down. They will never praise you, even when you're on top, because you're supposed to be doing that in the first place. You're supposed to be the guy on top. You're supposed to do all this stuff because you are a man, right? Well, they want equality. Remember this. While yelling equality, they expect you to do all this stuff and more. You will never surpass their expectations because you are supposed to be the man. Meanwhile, the losers, the people that don't give a crap, the people, the science experiments because you don't have to be handsome. That's a myth. It helps you to be handsome, but if you're handsome and have pecs, it doesn't really matter. I've seen people that look like hogs, that have no jobs, that they're midgets, like 4'11", not even 5 feet tall, that do this stuff. I've seen it. And they're already old and they're still doing the same thing. And those are the people that are being praised by their kids and wives. You know? So sorry that I'm looking down, but the light is too bright. So children that I don't have, I wish that I did. But if you see this, my little nephews, I gotta tell you something. We're not the same. Even as men, we are not the same. If you have to prove something, prove it to yourself. Because you are here by yourself and you are alone. Whatever it is that you take, appreciate it, embrace it, and whatever else, endure it and get stronger for you. Not for anybody else. If anybody else don't appreciate you, don't become a narcissist and saying, you don't appreciate. No. Take this as an experience. If you see that you're doing something wrong, if you catch yourself and you see everybody saying the same thing and they don't know each other, reflect, go to the book, ask God for guidance, ask God for strength, and He will give it to you. I'm a testament of it. God did things for me, tested me, and I saw a different person. And He took everything away because I couldn't handle it. He took everything away. Okay? Ask for guidance. Be patient with yourself. Reflect on yourself. Don't ask why. Just ask for strength to keep on going, and ask for wisdom so you can understand what, and you're going to start seeing all this stuff, like, even things that you're watching, you can analyze it better. Things get a little bit more, less murky. You can hear stuff that you didn't hear before. It's the little apocalypse. The veil gets open. You get to see people the way they are. Cause in my instance, I always, like I said in all the videos, I lie for entertainment, but I don't think that you are a liar. I take everything, not because I'm gullible. I take everything that you say at face value. Whatever it is you say, I believe it. Fine, good, great. But there are people that they lie to inflate their egos, to get something to... And I'm not saying like that is good, but I'm just saying this as a reference. You don't need to tell the truth to lie. You don't have to lie to protect the truth. You don't have to lie to protect the truth. The truth will come on its own. Because you're going to trip. You're going to trip. If you listen to this, to my nephews and anybody else that looks at me as a... I don't know. As an uncle. Don't lie. Don't lie to protect the truth. Do not lie to get away with stuff. To start a rumor just to lead people to the truth. Don't do that, because all you're doing is what is the word that I'm looking for? All you're doing is burying yourself and turning yourself into the problem. So everything is going to be looked at you like, oh, what else have you said? So now the truth is going to be hidden again because you're lying. You cannot lie. You don't have to say anything. Usually things happen. But if something happened and you see it, say the truth. Tell the truth. Even if it causes you to get fired. Even if it causes you to lose your business or whatever, if it's truth and it's going to save the majority of people, including yourself, if it's necessary. Because I became a cynic, and that's not a good thing. But I became very cynical with people because people don't want what they say they want. They tell you what they think they want, and then when they get it, they just drop it. They don't care. They ask you questions, not with the intent of learning, but to make fun of you. So there are some people that don't deserve saving. So you cannot save everybody. So sometimes staying quiet and letting the truth come on its own is necessary for your benefit. You are here by yourself. You will die by yourself. You get love and everything. But the moment that you get sick, an example that happened to me not far ago, you could be blowing up in fever. You can be feverish, dying, sweating, in agony. And people, females, will fight with you. They will make you feel like shit. And you tell them, you are killing me. And they just keep on going because they have that power. Just to see you squirm. People that you think love you, and maybe they do, when they see you down, they will destroy you. People that love you will tell you, oh my God, you're just aging bad. You're just getting old, whatever. Even though you're dying, they don't say, oh, how are you? Whatever. Like, for example, me, I try, but like I told you at the beginning of the video, I just found out that I have something. There's a reason why I'm like this. But I try not to, if I don't know you, I try not to make the obvious known because they already know this. They already wake up. People know what they are. I'm only like, I'm weird. I'm only funny, weird, and mean with people that I love, right? But to strangers and friends that I feel sorry for, I just try to make him laugh and talk about everything, but I just don't like talking to people. Seriously, I don't like people. So I don't know if that's a reflection. I'm getting what I saw. I'm ripping what I saw, right? So just remember that people that you think love you, and people that love you for real, they will always, if they're females, they will always kick you when you're down. I'm not the only one who says that. I'm just leaving it. And once you turn a certain age, I see all these people go to South Asia. It's the same thing. Once you go there as a bully, once you go there as a foreigner or as an American, they will treat you the same way as Americans treat you or Westerners. Because they're expecting you to behave a certain way. So all this passport, whatever, they're not telling you the whole truth. You are not special anymore. You are just a wallet. You might find love, but it's not what you expected. You're not going to get these models, these people with a lot of money. You might get people with kids. You might get people that are not the same wavelength as you, especially from South Asia. That's the worst part, because they're an ethno state. Well, it's not an ethno, a religious state, which is the worst of the worst. Because not only you, if you fall in love with somebody, you have to convert to a religion that is not a real religion. A religion that doesn't consider your religion valid. A religion that wants to destroy every other religion by coercion or buying anything. So, guys, focus on yourself. You will find that person. You will find that woman. Not person. You will find that woman. This is for heterosexual men. you will find that woman to procreate. But know that when you're down, you only have yourself or your best friend around. Maybe your mom, preferably your dad. But you are here by yourself, and it's not a bad thing. That's why you always have to have a little stash on the side, collecting dividends. Just know that if you find anything that gives you 25%, 20% of dividends, you could double that in 3 to 4 years. You can double your money in 3 to 4 years. The rule of 72. You divide 72 by the percentage that they're giving you, and you get the amount of years. Have your little stash, have your little land, somewhere that you can escape to. Read your books. Learn to work with your hands. I've been a fool willingly. I've been a fool without even knowing. And the life of a fool is miserable. Because the life of a fool is a life of chaos, of apathy, of laughing at sadness, at tragedy. So learn to work with your hands. Try to be stoic. And learn to be yourself. Look for what makes you you, what you like. Don't lie to yourself. It's okay if you lie to others, but don't lie to yourself. Love you. Terry Monegro, that's me. See you later.